What's up, everyone? Welcome back. I'm Blake McLain, and I'm a music producer. So today, doing One Direction, Take Me Home, Yearbook Edition. I know you guys have been asking for this for a while now. I did Youngblood this morning. I just figured I'd, you know, crank out two in a day. So give myself a little bit of time, and now I'm going to record this. Hopefully, I'll have it up by tonight. If not, it'll be a day or so. But I'm really excited about it. I've heard a couple songs on this, so quick disclaimer. You guys know I was actually listening to one in the car because I started this. But also, my sister used to listen to this album, or at least some songs from it, on the way to school whenever I'd take her to school when she was young. So, and funny thing, she actually bought a cake for Harry Styles and brought it to school and said it was his birthday, which is absolutely hilarious. Yeah, that being said, before we get started, as always, please give me a like, give me a subscribe if you enjoy the channel. I'm going to put my social media up top. Please give me a follow on Instagram or Twitter, whatever you use, and send me messages. Just drop comments. Give me suggestions for what you want to hear, what you want to see, and try and make it happen. I also put out a music video about a week and a half ago called Dirty Laundry, and I'd really appreciate it if you guys went and checked it out. Filmed everything in like a day. There's a ton of references in it too, which it's pretty cool, if you haven't already, you know, seen it. And it's on Spotify, iTunes, all that stuff as well, so please go check it out and let me know what you think. That's pretty much all that, so let's jump in, let's get started. Wait, how do I have no internet all of a sudden? What's up with this? Oh, I can go to this. Hold on. Okay, so weird skip there. Got my internet working. All right, let's go. So actually, that little cowbell is a little bit of like the response, because I always want to go like, come on and let me stick you out, da 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 da. Like that kind of a thing, but it still acts as a response because your brain kind of wants to hear that. And have a celebration, the music up, the windows down. Yeah, we'll be doing what we do, just pretending that we cool, and we know it too. Yeah, we'll keep doing what we do. So that's actually like, you know how there's the same line tale that I always talk about, where you have like, one line, exact same line, and then you do a different line, and it's just really catchy. This is like the opposite of that, because you can always switch it around. So you go one line, then you go same line. So it's like the tail comes first. Pretending that we're cool, so tonight, let's go. See how they just started adding in things like they added in the tambourine, the shika tikka 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 tikka, that kind of a thing. And they use a lot of white noise swells. You hear that shh, that kind of a thing. It's just white noise that they're actually fading in and then fading out whenever it hits. Since they ended in on power line there, you have to do a little bit of a musical break. You can't just come right in on that second verse or it's gonna feel too rushed. Hey girl, it's now or never. It's now or never. Don't overthink, just let it go. Go. And if we get together, yeah, get together. Don't let the pictures leave it alone. Oh, yeah. Another quick note. So notice it's like nice and rhythmic, you know, hey girl, it's now or never. Then it goes nice and elongated. Yeah, we'll be doing like we do. So it kind of gives it that nice contrast. Pretty much just being the responses, and then you bring the vocal back in, but notice how far back they're pushed in reference to like the actual main vocal. Tonight, let's get some and live while we're young. Another quick note, also I don't have my zebra mug because currently fixing it. I was walking and hit the ear on something, so I have to glue it. Which sucks. I just, you know, on every single album, his vocal sticks out to me, and it's like the way it's mixed too. It just sticks so far forward in the mix, and they might have to do that. I don't know. Too. So like I've, you know, it's funny because I did have to listen to some of these a lot when I was younger, and as I did drive my sister to school, and so some of this stuff stuck, and that's probably why I have a lot of the taste that I have as well, because I would hear that stuff over and over and over again. I'm like, gosh, this is ridiculously catchy, and like I wanted him, even though I haven't heard this in a minute, or hadn't heard this in a minute, because I was actually listening to it in the car, and I had the same little reaction. I wanted it to go up on the little bit before this, and then he does. He goes right up to that, if I were young. Like right up to that and lets it hold. No, we only met, but let's pretend it's love. And never, never, never stop for anyone. Tonight, let's get some and live while we young. So let's keep going. This is the one with the dance too. I remember because like, yeah, everything's coming back to me now. Logan used to, that's my sister's name. She used to have the DVD on this too. Oh, I just wanna take you anywhere that you like. We could go out any day, any night. Something like that. I can't remember. Oh my gosh. It's been a while. It's not that dumb thing. It's something else. I don't know. Maybe it's that. I don't know. You love on. You can get anything that you want. Baby, just shout it out. Shout it out. Baby, just shout it out. Yeah. And if you want me to. Quick note about this beat too. This beat is very similar. It's funny because they, on these first two albums, they knew kind of what the group wanted to, or what they wanted the group to be, and you can tell, because they wanted to play off of, and I realized this with the other albums as well, and that's what kind of led me to this conclusion. They wanted to play off of like classic rock songs and like hit rock songs, like 80s rock and stuff like that. Like what was the, What Makes You Beautiful is, what's this song? Oh my gosh, what is What Makes You Beautiful?
Cause that's what makes you beautiful. Oh, oh, I know you're beautiful.
What song is it? Oh my gosh, it's bothering the heck out of me. It's by, it might be by Pat Benatar. Or Joan Chad. I think it's Pat Benatar. Anyways, that aside. This one, Footloose, is what the play is off of. The beat is. So it gives you that kind of high-paced dance kind of feel. Let's make a move. Too. They did that nice swell and then let it go, and they add something in on the second half of that chorus. Take me home, baby, say yeah, 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 and let me kiss you. Oh, baby, baby, don't you know you got what I need? Looking so good from your head to your feet. Come on, come on. And see, notice too how these, like, the verses are a little bit faster pace and everything like that because of the drum beat. Like, it's not actually faster, it's just the beat is like not necessarily halftime, which the chorus is halftime. So you go from like this kind of a feel. See, because they came in with that little, and if you, you want me to, gosh, why can't I find it? And if you don't want me to, I don't know what it is. Anyways, because there was a lead in there, they can come in with the lead in for the chorus. It opens up that space. I was actually having that trouble in another song I was writing earlier today, and I realized, oh, that's the problem, duh. Like, I need to make sure that, you know, you have that nice contrast between, but it's difficult if you start on an offbeat or something to come in with a lead in for a chorus. Yeah, so tell me, girl, if every time we touch, you get this kind of rush, baby, say, and the nice change too with this bridge, like you kind of want it to feel like an aside moment. So this is a great transition into something that kind of gives you that that fulfillment. See, that's very like Ramones, like. The Nas necessarily aren't. Nas are more like pop punk kind of a thing, but like the or like kind of Blink 182, maybe that kind of a feel. So they just merged all these styles because they knew it would do well. I mean, if it did well once, it will again, you know? So tell me, girl, if every time we touch, you get this kind of. I love the high note. See, that is, oh, I always want songs to go there. You know, you save it, you save your range until the very end, and then you give it everything you got so it actually goes somewhere, you know? Cool, that was a little bit of an insight into like exactly how those group vocals sound behind everything. You know, you have the little pitched up ones. Alright, so let's keep going. Okay, so let's go little things. Alright. I love this song. Like, this is actually one of my favorite songs of all time. And it's funny, I talked about this in another video, but like I was trying to think of something not that long ago, and I was talking to a friend, and I was like, what is the most British sounding song I've ever heard in my entire life? We were trying to come up with it, and I was like, Little Things is the most British thing I've ever heard. Because, I mean, like, you almost can't sing it without it sounding British. Like, but you can't go to bed without a cup of tea. But maybe that's the reason that you talk in your sleep. And all those conversations are the secrets that I keep. Like, you really can't help it. Or what's the first line? No, you never love, or not the first line, but I know you never love the crinkles by your eyes when you smile, you never love. Like, you almost want to do that smile. You just can't help it. But the other thing is, I realized immediately, I was like, oh my gosh, this sounds like Ed Sheeran. And I looked and it was written by Ed Sheeran, of course. It just kind of has his little quirks in it. But I also always want to combine it with his song Supermarket Flowers. I'll take the supermarket flowers and stuffed animals. Though the day I'll see you from the pub, mom always said that you've done it when you're gone. And I always wanted to go. And I won't let these little things slip out of my mouth, but if I do, like that's always where I want, I hear it going, it's just funny. Alright, rant over, let's go. I'm stoked.
Hand fits in mine like it's made just for me. But bear this in mind, it was meant to be. And I'm joining up the dots with the freckles on your cheeks, and it all makes sense to me.
So the little response is the all makes sense to me. Like that's the response because you have the harmonies on top of it.
I know you've never loved the crinkles by your eyes when you smile, you've never loved. your stomach or your thighs.
Actually, I guess maybe I overdo that because I say like, no, you never love the crinkles by your eyes when you smile, you never love. Like that smile, I always hear it like, ah, that's weird.
The dimples in your back at the bottom of your spine, but I'll love them endlessly. I won't let these little things slip out of my mouth. But if I do, it's you, oh, it's you, they add up to.
Also, you had that little same line, but the tail came first.
I'm in love with you, and all these little things. You can't go to bed without a cup of tea, and maybe that's the reason that you talk in your sleep. And all those conversations are the secrets that I keep, though it makes no sense to me.
He does actually a little, it makes no sense to me. He actually like kind of bends his line a little bit. There's not a lot to talk about with this one. It's just kind of playing with their voices and stuff, you know?
I know you never loved the sound of your voice on tape. You never want to know how much you weigh. You still love to squeeze into your jeans, but you're perfect to me. I won't let these little things slip.
Also, that minor is what really does this, you know? It almost feels like it's going to be a pre-chorus, because it goes down to that little minor. It feels a little bit darker, and that's how you know it's a minor. This isn't going, otherwise I'd show you. But that's what kind of helps it do this and dip in and then pulls it out into that chorus.
Out of my mouth, but if it's true, it's you, they add up to, I'm in love with you. And all these little things, you'll never love yourself half as much as I love you.
I never noticed how much more forward his vocal is than where Harry's was. Harry's actually sounds a little bit clearer and crisper, but whenever he comes in, it's like they cut out a little bit of the highs, which is weird.
You'll never treat yourself right, darling, but I don't want you to.
Still love Niall's voice though.
If I let you know I'm here for you.
His is just, okay, over, like, if you look at everybody's voices, Harry has a little bit of, like, a little bit more grit, like, lower-end grit. Louis is a lot airier than everybody else's, and a little bit more worn, which is cool for, like, rock music and stuff. Zayn's a little bit more covered. Liam is just, like, almost like a mix of a lot of those guys. And then Niall is just really nice and clean, and you can almost hear it with his vocal, how like just spot on clean a lot of that stuff is. He's great in the range that he plays with.
Maybe you love yourself like I love you. Oh, and I've just let these little things slip out of my mouth, 'cause it's you.
It also just goes to show where everybody is singing from. Like, Harry is farther back here. 'Cause it's you. I can't even do that. 'Cause it's you. Oh, it's you. That's hard to, like, keep it here. But, like, Niall's a little bit more forward. Harry uses his chest voice a lot more.
Oh, it's you.
You.
Yeah. It's you. They add up to. And I'm in love with you. And all these little things, I won't let these little things slip out of my mouth.
Now you bring in all the harmonies for the very end, so it just feels a little bit bigger.
It's true, it's you, it's you, they add up to, I'm in love with you.
Something that I'm really happy that they did, and I never noticed it until now too, I know it paused a lot in the song, but actually this is kind of cool. They didn't perfectly line up their harmonies. A lot of times their harmonies are absolutely just dead on, and they'll do it over and over again until they get them perfect, or they'll like quantize them and make them spot on with like one, you know, so that way they're perfectly. But here, they kind of just let them sing almost as if they were being lazy about it, which is even cooler, and it kind of gives you this nice intimate feeling, like a raw, real feeling.
And all your little things.
Yeah. Oh, I thought there was a little bit more. Okay. I'm kind of really bad about pausing at like the very end of a song. All right. So let's go. Come on, come on.
Come on, come on, come on.
I love how they used real drums on like the vast majority of these songs. Like you can tell that's a real kick. It's meant for a stadium. Like it's got, it gets you right here dead center.
Standing alone. So come on, come on. Move a little closer now. Come on.
Calm response.
In the way you're walking now. Come on, come on. Show me what you're all about.
Guitar part in the very back that's almost like a pop punk lead. It's really high and it's like almost as if you're playing something like this. Like, where's my pick? It's almost as if you're playing something like, whoops, this is out of tune, but. Like something like that in the very back that's a little bit higher, maybe even like, wait. My pick is broken, that's why. Yeah. Anyways, I'm ADD today, guys. Alright, back to it. I need to throw this pick away. I think it's done. From something too. Anyways, call and response is there, and notice how they like pulled almost all of the like they pulled the hat out like from the drums and stuff like that, and just kind of stripped it back down to just kick and snare, you know.
The way that you let your head down, I can tell that you do.
Place his voice in a spot that helps it, the airiness sort of helps lift everything. Yeah, that makes sense. The airiness of his voice is helping kind of lift into the chorus. That's the point I was trying to make.
Come on, show me what you're all about, yeah.
Like the nice elongated note, and then you have the little rhythmic section, and that's the call and response for the chorus.
Music is alive. I wanna be us now. So come on, come on, and dance with me, baby. Every step I take, I'm feeling more and more. She is calling out, she's a lucky girl. My heart is racing, she is turning around.
Slow down was really cool too. They kind of just took that synth and did a, which super easy to do in like Logic. You just put a fade on it, you can right click it and press slow down, which is cool. Chucks in there, and that's giving it a little bit of grit. Yeah, nice little delay on his vocal at the very end too. It just gives it that huge stadium sound. Okay, so last first kiss. Also, I know that like the guys didn't write these ones, or they didn't have as much to do, or they weren't as involved with writing these ones. I don't know if Louis was or not on these. Let me see. Show credits. Yeah, Louis was. Oh. There were a couple that were. Okay, interesting. Anyways, so like, these were like really, they're very interesting to break apart because they're meant 100% to just be like hit after hit after hit after hit. And so you get a lot of, you get a lot of information from it, you know, and like you can learn about, you can learn a lot about what makes people sort of tick and what people like to hear in songs. All right.
Baby, I wanna know what you think when you're alone. Is it me, yeah? Are you thinking of me, yeah? We've been friends now for a while. I wanna know that when you smile. Is it me, yeah? Are you thinking of me, yeah? Oh, oh. Girl, what would you do?
See, the lift is great. So, like, it's gotta... it. Gives it a little bit of tension, makes it feel like it's going somewhere, you know, kind of puts you on your seat, and then you come down to the root note for the chorus, which I can't really remember this one, so I'm assuming that's where it's going.
Would you want to stay if I were to say I want to be left?
Da, ba, da, 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 da. So they go up to that root, you know? Oh, the nice delay on his vocal too, and they really brought it forward and gave it that airiness. And you can get that by kind of like pushing the mids of a vocal on an EQ.
Baby, tell me what changed. I'm afraid you run away if I tell you what I wanted to tell you. Yeah. Maybe I just gotta wait. Maybe this is a mistake. I'm a fool, yeah. Maybe I'm just a fool, yeah. Oh, oh. Girl, I'm
also notice a little skim that kind of helps transition into that section.
Would you wanna stay?
Great, you can have that chorus where it's super rhythmic too. I didn't even pick up on this the last time around because the little bit before was nice and elongated notes.
Wanna be first, yeah. Wanna be the first to take it all the way like this. And then
and you have the little telephone vocal there with the EQ where you push the mids, cut out the highs, and cut out the lows.
Girl, what would you do?
Yeah.
Would you wanna stay?
And there with those drums, just to create tension, you cut out all the highs of them and you slowly bring them back in. So it's like muddied, feels dark, and then it becomes clear and the last chorus feels way bigger because of it.
If I were to say your last
first
kiss,
I wanna be last, yeah. Baby, let me be your, let me be your last first kiss. I wanna be first, yeah. Wanna be.
I don't care what anyone says. I love this music. It's so good. Like, it really is good. It gets you, like, right exactly where it should. You know, it actually, like, gives you the tension, the release, everything. It's awesome.
So take it all the way like this.
Guitar part has really been driving almost this entire time, for the choruses at least. You know, and they haven't added and subtracted a lot for these, but it's interesting that they chose to do one more go with this. Sick. And see, like, oh, yeah. All right, let's keep going. You guys know I'm digging it. Okay, heart attack. Same guitar tone as Live While We're Young, almost exactly the same. It's got a nice punchy sound, and actually I've tried to get that guitar tone. It's really hard to get, unless you have the right guitar. It's hard to get on that one. You probably need like a Strat or something for it, something a little bit punchier. Baby, you got me sick. I don't know what I did. Need to take a break and figure it out. Yeah, got your voice in my head saying let's just be friends. Can't believe the words came out of your mouth. Yeah. And again, same line tail. Huge call and response. Oh, it's just, it's so catchy. Looking like you do, cause you're all I ever wanted. Thought you would be the one giving me a heart attack. I do want to say one more thing too, you know, like, all of these things I'm talking about, like, these songs are absolutely filled with them, but it doesn't necessarily have to sound like, some people might listen to this and be like, it sounds cheesy, you know, it sounds way too happy and way too upfront, but you can take literally this format exactly and you can put it with some minor chords and some different lyrics, some deeper stuff, and it will sound completely different but be just as addicting. And that's like my job as a producer, you know, if somebody gives me a song to take these formulas that make people, that pull their ear, you know what I mean, and then get them addicted to a song as fast and as quick as possible. You know, you want them to be able to listen to it one time through, actually in the first 8 seconds, you want them to be able to be hooked, stick out through the whole song, and then yeah, listen to it again. You know, I always say I write for the woman that's like, or the mom that's on her way to work and she's carpooling like 3 kids in the back and she's listening to the radio and that song comes on whatever I'm writing, and I have to make sure that it makes her day and that she doesn't switch the station. And that is the hardest thing, because she's pissed off, she's got so much going on, and you've got to pull somebody out of that mood and grab their attention, you know? It takes everything you have. Getting over cool. You. And it mimics the guitar, and I absolutely love it when things kind of mimic each other. They're staying in the same nice little pocket. I'm trying to be alright, but see you with him just don't feel right. And I'm like, oh, never thought it hurt so bad. Getting over you, damn, you're giving me a heart attack. Looking like you do, cause you're all I ever wanted. Thought you would be the one giving me a heart attack. There's actually some little kicks in there too. That they kind of have the volume pushed back just a little bit on those extra kicks, and it gives it a little bit more movement on these choruses. Back. I love that. So it gives it kind of this nice intimate feel, and that's what you want for that little breakdown bridge. Seeing you with him just don't feel right. And I'm like, oh, never thought it hurt so bad. Getting over you. You're giving me a heart attack. Looking like you do. Cause you're all I ever wanted. Thought you would be the one. Giving me a heart attack. Getting over you. Oh, stuff. And like, I know a lot of people don't like Simon Cowell anymore because reasons. But back then, I mean, he knew what he was doing when he put these guys together, and he decided what kind of music it was going to be. When they sat down with the team, like, they were so smart. Like, there's no way something like this could fail. And I mean, Up All Night, I've heard some stuff on that too. There's just no way. It's great, it's solid, and you have literally every possible tool that you could possibly use to make it work. Yeah. Called the owl too. Okay, let's keep going. Rock Me. Oh, this song. So I learned something about this a couple days ago. Chat's going crazy, trust me. Yeah, we're thinking probably the exact same thing, but it changed the whole meaning of it for me. I already figured, I had heard this before, and I already figured that it wasn't originally Rock Me, but yeah. And obviously it's a playoff of Queen.
Do you remember summer 09? Wanna go back there every night. Just can't lie, was the best time of my life.
Same line, tail.
Lying on the beach as the sun blew out. Playing this guitar by the fire too loud. Oh my mind, they could never shut us down. I used to think that I was better alone.
And notice there's really not going a lot, or not a lot going on, like instrumental. Wow, why cannot I talk? Every single video I say that I cannot talk today. But like, instrumentation wise, you know, you just have pretty much the acoustic, the bass almost sounds like it's a part of the acoustic, and then you have the drums underneath, and they're not that big yet, even though they sound pretty big.
Why did I ever wanna let you go? Under the moonlight as we stared at the sea. The words you whispered, I will always be.
What makes you beautiful is hit me with your best shot. That's it.
Hit me with your best shot.
Okay.
I want you to rock me, rock me, rock me, yeah. I want you to rock me, rock me, rock me, yeah.
The little bends on the guitar too are really cool, like on the actual, on the snare hits. Bring it back down to that acoustic, but you give it just a little bit more, especially with the shaker and all of that, so it feels like there's a little bit more movement on the second verse.
I used to think that I was better alone. Better alone. Why did I ever wanna let you go?
Let you go.
Under the moonlight as we stared at the sea.
Stared at the sea.
The words you whispered, I will always believe. I want you to rock me, rock me, rock me.
Actually, that's a lot like Beverly Hills, which I said I wanted to write a song for Louis, like Beverly Hills, but way more stripped down than this, you know what I mean? Doesn't have to be that big. Maybe still one day, if you guys push it hard enough, I would love to do that, that'd be sick. What was I gonna say? The other thing, this might be modeled a little bit after Def Leppard. I feel like this might be the other one that is.
Yeah, I want you to rock me, rock me, rock me, yeah. I want you to hit the pedal.
They were actually saying, they're saying rock, and I always thought it was I won't see Katie again, I won't see Katie again, which actually would have been really cool, because everybody would have been like, who's Katie? It reminds me of Mayday Parade also.
To rock me, rock
that also works really, really well because you have this nice static kind of da 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 da. Like it's very static, and then they move up the scale.
Hit the pedal, heavy metal, show me you can.
That's probably not high enough, but you get my drift. Like very static, and then as you start to move it up, it gives it that nice contrast.
Show me you can.
Like tasteful little runs there too.
Rock me, yeah. I want you to hit the pedal, heavy metal, show me you care. I want you to rock me, rock me, rock me, yeah.
Oh, I love the gang vocal too on it. Killer. Okay, keep going. Change my mind. See what happens with that too? Like there's not very much on his vocal, not very much verb, nothing. And like the acoustic is just kind of being plucked, and it's really up front as well, so it gives you that nice intimate feel.
We should say goodbye, but we carry on while everyone's gone. Never felt like this before.
I have heard this one. On something else, because I feel like it is. What is that used on? That's something. I feel like it's another song of theirs. I don't know.
But baby, if you say you want me to stay,
maybe I've just heard this.
I'll change my mind, because I don't want to know I'm walking away.
The feeling that the strumming on the guitar kind of gives you. I was actually doing this originally with my song Chandelier, which I have changed 15 times, I think. It's ridiculous. But anyways, like you give it kind of this kind of a strum, and it makes it almost feel like you can imagine two people in a room, the camera's like circling around them sort of a thing. If you ever, you know, need help with like writing a song, watch a scene in a movie or pick a music video, put it on silent, and try to write something to that. And a lot of times it helps because you can sort of personify exactly what's going on in the video with the music.
So maybe if you say you want me to stay for the night, I'll change my mind.
Gosh, the vocal sounds so young too, you can tell, because he hasn't fully found that mix yet, and so he's like a little bit more up front instead of kind of playing with both, you know?
When you laugh, you take photographs, there's no music on, but we dance alone. Never found like this before.
And up front that kick is too, it just gives it a little bit more oomph on this verse than the first one. But actually I really like where it hits, because it does hit you right here, and that's always the hard thing to do with the kick, but you want that, especially in this kind of music. Now you have that full shim-tin-tin-gun-gun-gun-gun-gun, which they weren't giving it all of it on that first chorus, but now they are, and that makes it feel like it's almost turning. I might just use this as a model a little bit. Okay.
Stay for the night.
right in with the melody that's being played on the synth in the back. So it kind of gives them just a really nice kind of in the pocket feel.
Baby, if you say you want me to stay, I'll change my mind.
And there's those filters again, so I know I'll pull it back because it's about to hit, but I have to say it before it hits. You throw that, you know, that high pass filter, so you cut out all the high frequencies, and then you just slowly bring them back in, and it gives you that nice build feel.
Change my mind. But baby, if you say you want me to stay, I'll change my mind. Cause I don't wanna go, I'm walking away. If you'll be mine.
Also notice on every other snare hit, you have the shka, which actually is mimicking like a hi-hat, like an open hi-hat. So it'd be like doom, doom, ga, goom, goom, ska, ga, doom, ska, like that kind of a feel. Definitely see though how like listening to Four and Made in the AM and Midnight Memories is like completely different, because I almost want to go listen to them now, because they are, it's just like they grew so much. Okay, let's keep going. So I would,
lately I found myself thinking, been dreaming about you a lot. Up in my,
a little call and response with a little delay.
Head, I'm your boyfriend, but that's one thing you've already got. He drives to school every morning.
Cool, so you start adding in the elements also. Same line, tail. And then you add the last line.
While I walk alone in the rain, and kill me without
actually, it goes three
anyone.
In the one. Actually goes three then.
What he says in that love VE. Well,
oh,
if it was me, then I would.
Yeah.
What he hold you when your feet lay low? Maybe you should know. I would. What he says in that love VE. Well, if it was me.
The lyrics so bad, but like, it's still great. You know, most of them, like, you don't actually listen to the lyrics for the first three times that you hear a song, and that's why like melody and everything is so important, you know, when you want to pull people in. But yeah.
Back in my head we were kissing. I thought things were going.
The little whistles as the call and response. I actually like those. Those are really cool. I'm gonna write that down. I might use that for something too. I'm getting all sorts of ideas.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah, so I was wrong. It isn't the same line, tail. It's three times and then the tail, which normally you would use on like a chorus or something, but it's fine to use it on a verse as long as on the chorus you do something a little bit different, you know?
It feels like I'm constantly playing.
Guitar.
Actually,
like finger picked guitar, that's cool.
Cause I can't compete with your boyfriend. He's got 27 tattoos. What he say is in a low VE. Well, if it was me, then I would. What he hold you with your feet.
I love those trashy drums too. Those trashy drums. Like, you can kind of get those. You cut out some of the lows on it, but you have to have like a room mic that you've used to capture the.
Maybe you should know the
probably
would,
yeah.
I would. What he say is in the low VE. Well, if it was me, then I would. What he hold you when you're feeling low? Maybe you should know.
The synth is actually hitting a little bit harder on this chorus too than it did on the previous one.
I would. Would you please
trashy drums from the chorus, but now it's just kind of that breakdown. On the cowbell.
Well, if it was me, then I would. Would he hold you when you're feeling low? Baby, you should know that I would.
And see, now using that white noise swell again, actually like a tone swell, like maybe a sine wave that they kind of, you know, started to pitch up.
Would he please you?
Kick is driving the whole time. The drums at the end too, those are sick. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, over again. I don't remember this one. Definitely don't remember this.
Said I'd never leave her, cause her hands fit like my t-shirt. Tongue tied over three words, cursed. Running over thoughts that make my feet hurt. Bodies intertwined with her lips. Now she's feeling solo, since she went solo. Hole in the middle of my heart like a polo.
I knew it. Oh my gosh, I just looked at the credits. Ed Sheeran. I knew it.
And it's no joke to
me. You can just tell. It's because he's jumping a lot of times, like his melodies sit there between like the root, the third, and the fifth, and he just kind of plays on those, which is the do, re, mi, fa, so, it's the do, mi, so, those are the three that he uses more than anything.
So can we do it all over again? If you're pretending from the start, like this, with a tight grip, then my kiss can mend your broken heart.
It's just so obviously Ed Sheeran. I can hear him singing this in 2 seconds.
I might miss everything you said to me, and I could lend you broken parts that might fit like this, and I will give you all my heart so we can start it all over again. Can we take the same road, 2 days in the same clothes, and I know just what you'll say if I can make all this pain.
I love the rhythmic change too to vocal, like you can tell he has a great sense of rhythm. Because he can kind of play with those.
Can we stop this for a minute?
And then go to
the I can tell that your heart isn't in it or with it. Tell me with your mind, body, and spirit. I can make your tears fall down like the showers that are British. Whether we're together or apart, we can both remove the masks and admit we regret.
Masks. Love it. So, like. You can tell this is a little bit different than the first verse, also because like there's some rhythmic changes big time because of the words that were being used and stuff like that, phonetically. But they also have a little click to kind of help move things along.
See from the start. If you're pretending from the start, like this, with a tight grip, then my kiss can make your broken heart. I might miss everything you said to me, and I can make your broken parts that might fit.
Kind of started adding in those guitars and everything to build it a little bit. So that's how it really fits into the style a little bit more.
And you'll never show weakness for letting go. I guess it's still hard if the seat's open. Do you really want to be alone? If you're pretending from the start, like this, with a tight grip.
See, that's so important to cut and go to that little bridge. Because think about it, if it wasn't there, it would just go straight into that chorus. And you got to bring it back down. You know, it's important to have a song that looks like this. It's nice and dynamic, but not, I mean, too much. You know, you want your sections to still work together, but you do want it to look like, okay, it's really like peaks and valleys kind of a thing.
My kiss can mend your broken heart. I might miss everything you said to me. And I could lend your broken parts that might fit like this. And I
like this and the tight grip, that's what really feels extra. Like this, the tight grip. Like, I could hear him singing, it almost reminds me of A-Team, which I'm sure this was about the same time period. But those are the little responses to the call, you know? It's also the line, the tail line, and then the same lines.
Start it all over again.
And hear how close they push his vocal for the very end there? Alright, back for you. This one sounds familiar. Palm mutes on the guitar, which is where you actually mute like the back strings on the guitar, and you gun. That way they're not playing full on.
The crowd, you're everywhere. I'm watching you from the stage, yeah. Your smile is on everybody.
I can almost predict exactly where this is going. I don't remember this one at all, but you can tell and you can feel where it's going. That's why the expectation is met, you know. Okay, maybe I'm wrong.
Goodbye, okay. Baby, you don't have to worry. I'll be coming back for you, back for you, back for you. You're gone, baby, I'll be going.
You hear what that does? So you have like a really nice rhythmic section, and then you just open it up to this nice elongated, everything comes together.
So I'm coming back for you.
Very similar to Kiss You, that's what it is, because I keep wanting to go back.
Touch, I only want more. So tell me nothing's gonna change, yeah, and you won't ever walk away.
Adding that tambourine. Or no, I'm thinking,
tell me girl, cause every time we touch.
Is that Kiss You?
Yeah, cause even though every night you know what I'll say.
Syncopated hits are great. Gun, 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 got him, got him.
I'll be coming back for you, back for you, back for you. You're a fool lately. I've been going crazy. So I'm coming back for you, back for you, back for you. You're my back for you.
It was cool to have the little, like, telephone kind of filter on the vocal, like right there before it goes into that that last bit. I was gonna say something else, I can't remember what it was. Oh yeah, the reason that those syncopated hits work so well is because it opens up the space and allows the vocal to be shoved forward, so it's like trading out that spotlight, you know. Note at the very end, you know, you save it to the end. Taylor Swift does it all the time in her stuff.
I'll be coming back for you, back for you, back for you. You're so lonely, I've been going crazy. So I'm coming back for you, back for you, back for you. You're so right back for you, right back for you.
And you just literally pull it to the full time. Beat here actually reminds me a little bit the doom got it. It reminds me of, maybe it doesn't 100% go radio, There's a song called Didn't I Know It? It's one of my favorite songs of all time. If you haven't heard it, go look it up. Actually, I'll play a little bit of it. Yeah, because you know, it's completely different. Hold on. I'm pulling it up, though. It's one of my absolute favorite songs.
Don't go to bed yet, love. I think it's too early and we just need a little time to ourselves.
And this will kind of show you, I'll just skip forward here in a second after this bit plays, because I love this. But it shows you, what is that sound? Oh, it's the water. Hold on. Forgot about that. It's like, what is going on? Why is it so loud the whole time? But it kind of gives you this, it just goes to show, like, you can use the same beat in different contexts. That's what I was getting at.
If my wall clock tells me that it's 4 in the morning, I'll give it hell. Cause I've been trying way too long to try and be the perfect song. When our hearts are heavy burdens, we shouldn't have to bear alone. So goodnight moon and goodnight you, when you're all that I think about, all that I dream about. How'd I ever breathe without?
And hear how it kind of has that same momentum. I'm gonna skip forward now. So let me see.
And there you were, last time I truly had come crazy. Pull down the stairs, we turned to miss the way her eyes light up the room. Until the end, do you feel us?
Gives you the same sort of feel, you know, but it's close to the same tempo, but it just goes to show you can use the same kind of basic feel in multiple contexts. Yeah, that's the point I was getting to. Okay, so let's do They Don't Know About Us. Okay, I have heard this one.
People say we shouldn't be together. Too young to know about forever.
This one has like a little bit more of like an R&B flair to it, but it's also like, especially with that intro, it's supposed to feel like nice and intimate, but it kind of has that like, turn down the lights, turn down the bed, like that sort of a feel to it, you know?
I say they don't know.
That's what the guitar is for too, that acoustic, to make it feel intimate.
They talking about this love is only getting stronger, so I don't want to wait any longer. I just want to tell the world that you're mine, girl. Oh, they don't know about the things we do. They don't know about the
interesting. So there's actually the big like trashy drums in the back, the trashy snare, but then there's another snare. It's like a little 808, just a little 808 snare, like on the offbeat, the syncopated beat. Listen.
If they only knew that they would just be jealous of us. They don't know about the all night. They don't know I've waited all my life just to find a love that feels this right.
Bigger that guitar feels to the electric guitar feels huge in comparison to the acoustic, but the acoustic is still there, it's still driving the rhythm.
They don't know about us. One touch and I was a believer. Every kiss it gets a little sweeter. It's getting better, keeps getting better all the time, girl. They don't know about the things we do. They don't know about the...
I never noticed that. I guess just because the chorus is what's stuck in my head always, but like, That's weird. They only went to the second verse for like a bar, like that's it, and then they just jumped right back in. But I guess hook them in, keep them there with the chorus. Okay.
I love yous, but I bet you if they only knew, they would just be jealous of us. They don't know about the earth all night.
That's gotta happen too. Somebody has gotta do that. No, the. Which, again, I don't really 100% remember what happens, but, like, somebody has it.
Just in the dust. They don't know I'm waiting on.
gotta love the feels, feels right. Baby, they don't know about, they don't know about us.
They don't know about.
That's the one. That's the one that I used to.
They don't know about us.
Who you are. They don't know what you've done to me. They can say anything they want, cause they don't know us. They don't know what we do best. It's between me and you, our little secret.
Okay, I was thinking maybe that little underneath, I didn't realize it was strings at first. It almost sounded like what the Beatles use, like the, what's that? My brain is, I'm losing it. Totally losing it today. What kind of piano is it? It's like an electric keyboard, but it has like a honkier sound to it.
But I wanna tell them, I wanna tell the world that you're mine. They don't know about the things we do. They don't.
Hold on, okay, I hope he does it. I hope he does it.
About the heart, the but I bet you they only knew. They only knew. They would just be jealous. They would just be they don't know about the night. They don't know what we are.
I believe in Zane. I believe in him. Come on, dude.
The feels is right. It's so right. Baby, they don't know about me. They don't know about us. We do. They don't know about us.
I'm hearing these in my head and I really want him to do them, but I don't think he's going to. I'm kind of upset.
Baby, they don't know about, they don't know about us.
Nice swell out at the very end though. Bring it right back to where it started.
They don't know about us.
So I wanted this, and it's very Zane. It would be almost like best song ever where he does that.
Best song ever! Best song ever!
It's actually a little bit.
Best song ever.
Tell the world
anyway,
that you're mine, girl.
I'm really bad. Sorry.
They don't know about it. We do. They don't know about the love. The use of the love that you do. We knew. They only knew. They would just be jealous. They would just be jealous.
Like, do some of those, you know, the
just be jealous of us.
I'm not going to do, like, the full, like, yeah. Head voice because I have neighbors and they'll flip their shit. But yeah, you got me. Okay, so okay, Summer Love.
Can't believe you're packing your bags, trying so hard not to cry.
Okay.
Had the best.
Same line, little tail.
Now it's the worst time, but we have to say goodbye. Don't promise that you're gonna ride. Don't promise that you'll call. Just promise that.
So you're playing off the offbeat there. So really and truly, you only have two options for the chorus. That's my mom. She likes to leave her phone on loud all the time, every day. She can call her back. Anyways, so you only have two choices for that chorus. One is to like come right in on that beat one, or two is to go to an offbeat again, unless you provide enough space for a lead.
You won't forget we had it all. Cause you are mine.
So they gave it enough space with that last little line.
For the summer.
And then nice and rhythmic as the response.
Summer love. Wish that we could be alone now.
Love it when he takes second verse.
We could find some place to hide. Make the last time just like the first time. Push your button and rewind. Don't say the word that's on your lips.
It's a really nice chord change there too for that that pre-chorus. It really gives it like a nice kind of change, a nice contrast between the verse and the chorus.
Give me that way. Just promise you'll remember when the sky is gray. 'Cause you are mine for the summer. Now we know it's nearly over.
I mean, you saw I was definitely playing that on the verse, but this is definitely the right spot to bring it. Sorry, I'm still like caught up on that note on They Don't Know About Us, because I want it to sound like, I'd have to do it just when nobody's here, but like, I want it to sound like, what's the song? Best Song Ever. That best song ever. Like that, that's what it needed to do. Anyways. Giving it that nice big snare, and I'm assuming here it's gonna do like a dang cut and then go into the just keep the top end strings there.
Feels like snow in September.
Pretty sure there was like a police sound in the back of that. That's interesting. Once that was outside. So, let's go to She's Not Afraid. There's that tone again. This one's a little bit higher though, like a little bit. Actually, it might just be the chord that they're playing, but it's very similar to the same tone as Live While We're Young, that kind of thing. This is gonna bother me, what is this?
Dress with the top color. She's addicted to the feeling of letting go. Oh, let go. She walks in the room, just lights up, but she don't want anyone to know.
This is just like something, and maybe this one's Footloose, more Footloose. It might be.
If I'm the only one that gets to take her home.
No, it's not.
Oh, take her home. But every time I tell her that I want more.
Using that acoustic to kind of help, you know, transition in. Also, there's an acoustic that's playing with the drums a little bit, kind of giving it a little bit of rhythm. Gotcha.
Closes that door. She's not afraid of all the attention. She's not afraid of running wild. How come she's so afraid of falling in love? She's not afraid of scary movies.
There's again, you know, you're playing with that same line, and then you kind of go into a, so you're, it's very static melody, and then you kind of play with it, make it a little bit dynamic, you know, move up the scale.
Maybe she's just trying to test.
They really love the slowdowns on this too.
Wanna see how hard I'm gonna work. Wanna see if I can really tell how much she's worth. Watch her work.
Notice where they place the vocals. They're all in different spots. You know, they kind of bring some forward and push some back. That way it always feels like it's pumping.
She's not afraid of all the attention.
She's not afraid of running. What was that? What was that? Sounded literally like a trumpet. She's so afraid of falling in love. She's not afraid of scary movies. She likes the way we kiss in the dark. She's so afraid of us but falling in love. What about all the things we say? Talking on the phone. Nice, so they throw that verb on there to kind of give it that that what about all the things we say, you know, it's like an aside kind of thought away from everything else. So you can throw a verb on it and it just kind of accentuates that lyric a little bit.
When I say that I can't do it no more, she's back in my door.
I like the little accents too. This one's probably the most awkward feeling of all of them, but it's still smooth. I mean, is because like the transition from that pre-chorus into the chorus almost feels a little too sudden, you know what I mean? Like it doesn't smooth in super well. So that's the only thing that was bothering me a little bit. What? What a weird end. Yeah, definitely the most awkward song. Okay, so let's go to Love You First.
Girl, it's your name. Driving to your house, knocking on your door.
Super similar to Live While We're Young. Again, same kind of guitar tone, but it almost feels like, hey girl, I'm waiting on you. I'm waiting on you.
Kissing you on the mouth, holding on your hand, dancing in the dark. Cause I was the only one who loved you from the start.
A little response.
Chances could have been where he is standing. That's what he's supposed to. You're like it's so close.
That's a pretty big delay on that vocal too.
Baby, I loved you first. Girl, it should be me. Calling on your phone, saying you're the one and that I'll never let you go. I never understood love is
just. Actually, this is interesting too. It's almost like they start his vocal a little bit farther forward on the verse and then pull it back a little bit, and then the next vocal that comes in, it's a little bit louder than the one prior, probably to give it a little bit of motion.
I felt it for the first time looking in your eyes. And now when I see you with him,
same line, tell.
I've been waiting all this time to finally say it. When I was
there's some little chucks on the guitar there too, though. Guys.
I've been taken and nothing could be worse. Baby, I loved you for the time. My chances could have been where he is standing. That's what hurts the most.
Girl, you know what's kind of cool about these two? They're using guitar on the choruses, but they're also using synth lined up with the guitar, so it sounds like they're almost one instrument.
So close,
that's what gives it the modern feel.
Oh, baby, I loved you first touch, first kiss, first go.
And then they have that.
Yeah.
That's what I keep hearing. I've been waiting forever and a day. What is that? That's something.
Yeah, but now I see your heart's been taken. Nothing could be worse.
Baby, I loved you
my chances. I love the guitars. I love the guitars. Shot snare, obviously huge fan.
Baby, I love you first. Baby, I love you first. Oh yeah. Baby, I loved you first.
There's another slowdown. Okay. Let's keep going. Nobody compares. Okay. All the high end taken out of the, or not high end, all the low end taken out of the guitar and the drums.
Cry when you cry, wasn't ready to hear you say goodbye, now you're tearing me apart.
Actually, a lot taken out of his vocal too, and sort of pushed back. That way, when everything does come in, it feels way bigger.
Me apart, you're tearing me apart. You're so London, your own style, your own style. We're together, we're so good.
Tail line, then the same line. Okay, so you keep adding things in, you bring in the tambourine, you know, kind of keep building. Again, on that, every couple snares, you hear the shka. It's like every four bars.
Tell me how to make it right. Now all of my friends say it's not really worth it. Even if
it's every other snare, actually.
No one in the world could stop me from not moving on. Maybe even if I wanted to, nobody compares to you.
Do the same thing again, cut out literally all the lows.
We're so Paris when we kiss, when we.
Then when you bring in the drums, actually it really kind of gives it up.
I remember the taste of your lipstick. Now you're tearing up my heart, tearing up my heart. You're tearing up my heart.
Did I do something stupid? Yeah, girl, if I blew.
See how they cut everything too for that vocal right before the chorus, for that lead in. You know, it's a great way to transition into a chorus.
Cause no one ever looks so good in a dress, and it hurts cause I know you won't be mine tonight. No one ever makes me feel like you do when you smile, baby. Tell me how to make it right. Now all of my friends say it's not really worth it.
You hear how that melody just kind of allows it to sort of just what's the word that I've been using the entire time, kind of elongate out, you know, kind of let it ride, you know?
If that's true, no one in the world could stop me from not moving on. Baby, even if I wanted to, nobody compares to you. Nobody compares to you.
I really want an alternate melody now. I really want one there.
There's gotta be some way to get you to want me.
Like over top of the vocal.
Cause no one ever looks so good in a dress, and it hurts cause I know you won't be mine tonight.
Even if that's true,
you know, they kind of do the same thing here that they do on a lot of the other ones, and I needed to say something, because I got to pause every once in a while, but, like, they bring in all the harmonies, sort of, closer to the end of the, on the second half of those choruses, you know, to give it the oomph. Again, alright. A song, Still the One. All I can think of is Still the One. The, oh my gosh, Shania Twain. What's the... I used to sing it all the time. Still the one I run to. The only one I dream of. Still the one I kiss. Good night. Still the one. Oh, looks like we made it. Look how far we've come now, baby. I was actually going to audition for The Voice with that song. But I listened for The Voice a lot of times. Never even got past round one. Crazy. Alright, let's keep going.
Hello, hello, I know it's been a while, but baby, I got something that I really want to let you know. Yeah, something that I want to let you know.
Adding the harmonies on for that second little bit of the verse.
Couldn't blame you, cause I know I left you all alone. Yeah, I know that I left you all alone. Yeah, now I'm back at your door.
Love the cowbell again.
You're looking at me unsure. I should have seen it before. You're all I think about, baby. I was so stupid for letting you go.
Interesting. Okay, so they really start cutting it up here on this chorus and, like, providing a little bit of that space again for the vocal. They've done that a lot on this album.
I know you're still the one. You might have moved on, but girl, you should know.
It's because they cut out most of the instruments except for the hits.
I know you're still the one. I know it's saying too much.
There's an acoustic guitar behind that, too. To kind of just play with the rhythm.
I'll never give up.
For that verse, you know, that way it feels like there's a nice contrast between the chorus and the verse.
I keep talking, begging, tell me what I wanna hear. Yeah, girl, just tell me what I wanna hear. I try to start again and find somebody.
I just had another idea. Oh, I just had another idea. I gotta write it down really quick. Use. Okay.
But I remember all the times and all the words he said. Yeah, I can't get it out of my head. Yeah, now I'm back at your door.
They were bringing that cowbell for just a quick second.
You're looking at me unsure. I should have seen it before. You're all I think about, baby. I was so stupid for letting you go. But
drums are just huge, cannon shot snares, like, I mean, it really, those are stadium drums, and I
have moved on, but girl, you should know that I know you're still the one. I know it's saying too much, but I won't ever give up. I was so stupid for letting you go.
Another one of those, like, it's just the sine wave that they kind of drop the pitch. Sick. I kind of wish they would have kept his vocal, like, just go in there. Awesome, and it kind of ends the same way it starts too, the same guitar tone and everything, and no fade outs. I know, that's like a thing now, I can't help it, but they didn't even have a single one on this, nuts. Yeah, killer album. I'm probably going to go back and listen to a couple things because I wrote down some stuff that I'm probably going to take note of and use in my own music, so I'm excited. Still finishing up my EP, and this should help me a little bit. I'm pretty stoked. So thanks for hanging around. I appreciate y'all, and I think my favorite on this one, probably, I don't know. I'll write it down in the comments. I'll let you know. All right. Catch y'all later.